Sometimes, without us realizing, things we do end up making a huge mess. When this happens, there are a couple of things we should do. First, stop things from getting any worse. Second, try to clean up as best we can. But what if it's a really big mess? A life-threatening, planet-sized, climate-cooking mess. It's hardly news that the Earth is heating up and we're to blame. Climate change threatens to unleash disaster. Melting ice caps, rising sea levels, drought, expanding deserts. We are gradually taking steps to turn things around. We all know about recycling and using green energy, but less well known are the possibilities for undoing the damage we've already inflicted. That's the big idea behind what's known as carbon capture. But to understand how it works and whether it's the solution to the climate crisis, we first need a little reminder of the problem. Today, we generate most of our energy by burning fuels made primarily of carbon, a process which releases carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Now, a little CO2 in the air is fine. In fact, it's essential. Plants absorb it and release oxygen that animals like us need to breathe. But over the last couple of centuries, our overenthusiastic, industrial-scale burning of these fuels has begun upsetting this cycle's delicate balance. CO2 levels are rising every year, clogging up the atmosphere, preventing heat from escaping into space, warming the planet, and driving climate change. Even if we cut our emissions to zero tomorrow, the stuff already out there will go on trapping heat for centuries to come. So averting the climate crisis doesn't just require lowering emissions. We also need to give the atmosphere a deep clean. Okay, so should we just plant more trees? That's worth doing, but creating new ecosystems is incredibly complex and challenging, requiring lots of time, space, and careful management, all of which we're failing to provide for those that already exist. Besides, trees only store carbon until they die and rot, or burn in a fire, which climate change is making more common. So if trees alone aren't the answer, perhaps we can engineer more effective forms of carbon capture. The simplest method is called direct air capture, where CO2 is trapped as air blows through chemically treated filters, like a power plant, in reverse. In fact, filters could be installed in power plants, and by burning wood chips instead of fossil fuels, they could be made even more carbon efficient. There are other options too. Soil and some kinds of rock store carbon naturally, and this can be enhanced, for example, by fertilizing fields with a kind of charcoal made from waste plant matter, or scattering finely ground silicate rock that reacts with CO2. And these are just a few examples. The possibilities being explored here are incredibly wide-ranging and could potentially remove enormous quantities of CO2 from the atmosphere, returning it to pre-industrial levels. But the key word there is potentially. To understand what I mean, take the world's largest DAC plant, Climeworks Orca facility in Iceland, which can capture up to 4,000 tons of CO2 a year. That sounds like a lot, until you realize we'd need 250,000 such plants to capture the estimated billion tons per year needed to go carbon negative. But that's not the only problem. Imagine we hit this ambitious target. What then? What do we do with a billion tons of carbon dioxide a year? The obvious solution is put it back where we found it, in the mines and oil fields where it lay for millennia, and hope it doesn't leak out. But there's an alternative, because carbon isn't just a pollutant. It's a natural resource we already use for lots of things. For example, as an ingredient in materials like concrete and plastic. So instead of burying it, we could build with it. Or, by combining it with hydrogen, we can make high-octane fuels to power aeroplanes. But wait, plastic and jet fuel? We're going to clean up the CO2 polluting our atmosphere, then use it to pollute the environment again? Obviously, that sounds crazy, but it demonstrates an important point. Effective change happens by degrees. It would be great for CO2 levels if aviation stopped overnight. Realistically, though, that's not going to happen. But if recycled fuel could help make the industry carbon neutral and attract investment to carbon capture, that would be a huge step in the right direction. Unlike climate change itself, carbon capture is a topic of genuine debate, and it's easy to see why. What could be a crucial tool might easily just become something for businesses and governments to hide behind, promising to clean up the atmosphere someday while continuing to spew out carbon. Given how little time we have left to prevent a disastrous temperature rise, we can't afford to make the problem worse today, assuming we'll have the technology to solve it tomorrow. But alongside renewable energy, reforestation, and many other approaches, carbon capture has an important role to play in both stopping the problem getting any worse and cleaning up the mess we've already made.